Hi, Christian Chase with Chase Real Estate and Chase Foreclosure. I'd like to take a little bit of time to talk to our investors about basements and leakage in the basements. So often investors will buy properties and they will go ahead and start the renovation, and maybe 4 weeks, 5 weeks in, all of a sudden we get a large rain or snow begins to melt and the property now starts to get leakage within the basements. One of the key things our investors should be paying close attention to, and I also say this to our renovation contractors or any renovation contractor, the day you close on the property, you buy the home in foreclosure, you're going to be changing out the locks and securing the property for yourself. At that time, we should be putting on gutter downspouts, extensions around the entire property. And I think it's critical that our investors know this, our renovation contractors know it, so that it's an expectation that's set early on. Once you've closed on the house, locks are being changed and new gutter downspouts are being installed. Now, the gutter downspouts we put on day one may not be permanent gutter extensions. They may just be temporary ones that we're using just to help dry out around the foundation. The big issue with a basement that's getting leakage in it is it's not that the water is always going to be pouring through there. The problem is so many of these foreclosed properties, it's got deferred maintenance. No one had extensions on their gutters, and maybe it's grated improperly. And what ends up happening is all the water pools around the foundation of the house. And where is that water going to go? It's going to find the smallest, tiniest of cracks and move into that foundation. But if we address it early on in the whole process, the day that we close on the property, we put on these temporary gutter downspouts to divert the water away from the foundation, what'll happen is we're drying the soil out around the foundation itself. We're not going to make it completely dry, but we're going to be drying it out. It's not like a pool of water sitting around the foundation with the pressure coming in. And so then after 5 weeks, that soil is dried out around the foundation itself. And the water then, and if it was to rain, the water's being diverted with these gutter downspouts. It percolates through the soil, and the water has somewhere to go. It doesn't have that pressure pushing on the foundation itself. And that's where we get a lot of those leaks. So a really, really simple fix to a major problem. And this past year, we've had a lot of rain, and as a result, we've had lots of water issues. But the one thing I've noticed is what we're looking at right here is this is what I see on a majority of properties, is the whole home is being renovated and all the gutter downspouts are laying all over the place. Water's running right along the foundation. We're not giving the foundation or the soil enough time to dry out. So when you put the home on the market, magically, that's when we get all of the rain, and then voila, we've got water in our basement. So we want to make sure that we're addressing that. There's another thing that you're going to notice within basements, and there are a lot of solutions. Sometimes you're going to have a crack that's going to be a continual leak. That's like an epoxy injection. That's rather inexpensive and not something that I'm overly concerned about. If we had a significant water issue, let's say we just constantly got it from all different places within a foundation, we could run a drain tile around the interior perimeter of the basement, and the water can run into this drain tile, then into a sump pump and out. So that's a simple solution. There's something else that we also notice in basements, since I'm talking about water. A lot of times these homes, the water will, or the sewer will back up, and you'll see like a round thing of sludge, like in right around a floor drain in the basement. And that's sewer, that sewage coming back up. And what I encourage all investors to do is, one, if you do notice that, you want to get that rotted out right away. And then what we want to install on that drain itself is a backflow preventer. So the water that comes back through the sewer up to the floor, it can't push up through that. It's got a little valve there that keeps it shut. Only water coming from the basement downward can flow downward back into the sewer line and out to the street. So a lot of little things, we can solve water problems relatively easy. I would say the number one item is getting the gutter downspouts. And when we say extending a gutter downspout, it's not extending it 2 feet or 3 feet away. I want to go 14, maybe 16 feet out with these gutter extensions to get the water completely diverted away from the foundation. It's a simple, simple fix. And when the home gets on the market, we're not getting calls or quality control inspectors aren't reporting leaky basement. And if it is a leak, they tend to be very, very small. That is an epoxy injection fill and something that costs us very, very little to do it, and saves us thousands of dollars, saves buyers, home inspections, all of those things are solved by installing gutter downspouts the day that you close on the property. As always, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to give me a call and check out our website, chaseforeclosure.com.